The Bible, the infallible Word of God. Since its creation, everybody has accepted it as such because of the many truths that lay within. However, Satan came to Earth and possessed a naturalist named Charles Darwin, and using his body, he collected volumes of evidence that proved that a monkey gave birth to a man, thus creating atheism. This is the only alternative to God's creation story, and it's obviously a lie. These evidences, however, along with the evidence that followed for a century and a half, were all fabricated. The thousands of transitional forms were really just strangely shaped rocks. The DNA evidence that by itself would be sufficient to prove that man descended from apes also isn't real because no one's ever seen DNA. And the geological column proves nothing because carbon dating doesn't work. Take this rock, for example. A Christian website told me that if I tried to carbon date this, which is a complicated process that makes my head hurt whenever I try to understand it, I'll get a false reading. Never mind that this rock doesn't have any carbon in it and would therefore render carbon dating futile. The Christian website has to be right because it advocates God, and those who support him will go to heaven. Those stupid atheists. Accepting little pieces of evidence that are clearly false just so that they can sin. Because everybody knows that if Jesus is in your heart, you will never sin. And even if you do, you'll pray for forgiveness and that will make everything better. Right? Here I'm going to give you complete evidence that's totally logical and proves that the Bible is the Word of God. Get ready, atheists. You're about to become Christians. Let's look at some scripture first. Genesis 2:13. And the name of the second river is Gihon. The same is it that compasseth the whole land of Ethiopia. Ethiopia is a real place, atheists. Just look at a map. See? There it is! Already we have proof that the Bible is true. Matthew 24:36-37 says that no one will know the hour or the day that Jesus will return. And this is true. Throughout history, people assembled to prepare for the rapture because false prophets claimed that they knew that Jesus would come back. Just look at Harold Camping. He always gets it wrong. And the reason is because no one can know. This is proof that the Bible is right. Because nobody knows. That's like saying that nobody knows when aliens will contact us. And it's just as impressive, and for the same reason. In Luke 21:23-24, Jesus said that non-Jews will trample over Jerusalem. This prediction came true only 40 years after Jesus prophesied it. Well, give or take, because nobody knows, you know, the exact day that Jesus was born. I mean, no, he was born on December 25th, zero. End of story, period, has been proven. Here's the big one. The Bible prophesies that the Jews would return to Israel. And they did! After World War II, the United Nations made Israel a Jewish state. Wow! I mean, can you believe it? This is the biggest piece of evidence that the Bible is true. Nervous atheists? You should be. You better repent right now. And here's the coolest one of all. In this verse of Exodus, God appears before Moses in the form of a burning bush. Now get this. Just yesterday, I was screwing my girlfriend. In fact, I was doing such a good job that she was saying and shouting, "You're on fire!" among other things. Did I mention that she has a bush? So I was on fire, metaphorically speaking, while entering her bush. We have a burning bush. Still not convinced? She kept on screaming, "Oh my God!" So put it all together, and you get me burning my girlfriend's bush while she screams God. Coincidence? I think not. And the Bible is even better if you read the original Latin and Hebrew, because those words can be converted into alphanumeric code to produce prophecies. In fact, you can even do this with some English passages. Let me show you. Judges 14:1. And Samson went down to Timnath, and saw a woman in Timnath of the daughters of the Philistines. There are 18 words in this verse, and the 18th letter of the alphabet is R. Remember that. Now look at the word Samson. It has two words in it, see? Sam and son. The actor Sam Worthington, who was born after the Bible was written, is the son of a man named Ronald, whose name begins with R. You see? Sam is the son of Ronald. Coincidence? I think not, atheists. Only an idiot wouldn't be convinced by all of this evidence. So go put Jesus in your heart, and may the crocoduck be with you. La 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 la